Anochi Adonai Elohecha Asher Hotzeitecha Me'eretz Mitzrayim. The very first words of law that we receive that make up our entire structure of this legal system that we now call halakha, this evolving structure, begins with the Ten Commandments and that very first commandment that says, I am the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt. Anochi, I, even if it's God's voice, a communal legal structure begins with the word I. So I want to ask you this morning, if given the opportunity to have a blank canvas to start over, how would you build our legal system from scratch? In this same Torah portion, after receiving these same laws, we have a section where Jethro sets up a system of judges, the high courts and the low courts, telling Moses that he can't do it all himself. Would you throw away what we have because some of it is flawed, or at least flawed based on our 2021 view of society in the world, not necessarily based on societal norms in the era in which it was codified? Or would you try to improve upon it? As the conservative movement and conservative Jewish ideology suggests, that our legal process is an evolving one. From an American standpoint, that is the question at the root of the one-woman off-Broadway show, What the Constitution Means to Me. And while Broadway and theater have been closed for far too long because of this pandemic, if you are looking for the latest thing to stream while you are sitting at home, What the Constitution Means to Me is now streaming on Amazon Prime and highly recommended by me. The show, written and starring Heidi Schreck, begins with her flashing back to her time as a teen, where she would write essays about what the Constitution means to her and give those speeches at local American Legion halls to earn scholarship money. In one part of the show, she actually reads word for word from a speech that her 15-year-old self once delivered. At its core, the show focuses, though, on how the Constitution, which begins in the preamble with the words, we the people, left most people, essentially non-white males, specifically women, Black people, Native Americans, and immigrants, out of the picture when framing that legal system. Each performance of the show concluded with Schreck bringing on a local high schooler, a teen at a high school in New York City who was on their school's debate team. And the two of them would debate about whether or not we should throw out the Constitution entirely and start over, or we should take this structure that we have been given and build upon it, improve upon it. And then the beauty of the show is that the audience would vote. And depending on the debate performances, depending on who Schreck was debating, which high schooler, sometimes the audience members will raise their hands and vote to get rid of it entirely. And sometimes they would say, no, we have this core to build upon. It's far from perfect, but it's a start. As Lin-Manuel Miranda acknowledges in his Broadway musical, Hamilton, even our founding fathers acknowledged that the Constitution was flawed. This first legal document in this experiment that we call America was something, not everything, but something to build upon. As Hamilton and Burr debate in Nonstop in the Act One finale, the Constitution's a mess, so it needs amendments. It's full of contradictions, so is independence. We have to start somewhere. No way. You're making a mistake. Good night. Hey. Sounds better when Lin-Manuel Miranda's rapping it, I promise. That's where we find ourselves as Jews, as conservative Jews. This balance, holding our legal system that we believe is righteous and holy, but also ancient and flawed, trying to have it evolve so it still makes sense to us as a spiritual code, literally halakha, the way for us to walk in modern times. To find the balance, as we say at Bethel, between preserving tradition and embracing change. And as we just read in Parshat Yitro, as we experience Matan Torah, revelation at Sinai, and receive the very first part of our legal system, the Ten Commandments, we acknowledge that these commandments are divided up, as our rabbis teach us, between Ben Adam L'Makom, those which relate to our relationship with God, and Ben Adam L'Chavero, those that are about interpersonal relationships, that focus on our relationship with each other. But rabbinic commentary chooses to focus on that very first word of our legal system, Anochi, I. Even if it is God speaking in the first person, it is odd, they suggest, that a legal system that focuses on communal obligations begins with the singular, begins with the individual, begins with the word I. After all, the flaw that Heidi Schreck points out in the Constitution is that it's really not about we the people, but instead about we, a very select group of people with an immense amount of privilege. We know that our own legal system, our Torah, is a tree of life only if we cling to it. But we also know that it evolved through a society, a part of Judaism that for centuries was dominated by a patriarchal society, ignoring or erasing women's voices that are far too often not found in the verses of Torah, that we have to search between the verses, between the letters. As Rabbi Nachman of Bratslav said, we have to look for the white space between the black ink to find the missing voices. And for many years, that same legal system propped up homophobic societal norms as well. So we're left similarly wondering if the Anochi, the I standpoint, that's the very beginning of our Jewish legal system, is similarly flawed as the Constitution is, as this off-Broadway show suggests the Constitution is. For it denies the presence of the diversity of what a Jew and what a Jewish community looks like today. And even thousands of years ago, when Bnei Israel left Egypt, accompanied by an Erev Rav, by a mixed multitude of individuals, standing at the foot of Sinai, embracing that diversity, waiting to receive a Torah that very well could have ignored that communal diversity at first. Rabbinic commentary also acknowledges that Anochi is an odd structure for the Hebrew word I, compared to the more commonly used Ani. Panim Yafot, the Hasidic commentator, references another time in which Anochi is used and stands out. When Jacob awakens from his dream, after seeing angels on a stairway to heaven going up and down that stairway, Jacob says, "V'adonai b'makom hazeh v'anochi lo yadati." Anochi, in that statement, that God was in this place, and Anochi, I, Jacob says, did not know. Panim Yafot understands that extra kaf, which turns the Hebrew word ani into Anochi, means that that word means something different than our typical selfish I statement. We expect when somebody says I that they are putting themselves before you, or the communal we. But the commentary expounds that this Anochi, Jacob says, and I would argue the Anochi that we find the very first words of our legal system, means that it's only possible for a person to attain the high rung of being able to say, as Jacob did, that God was in this place when they get rid of all sense of ego from their personality, from their sense of self, from their being. Panim Yafot is suggesting that the I use here, that Anochi, the very beginning of our legal system, is ultimately about humility. And that is the essence of Torah, to be humble. The rest is just commentary. A legal system that truly is a tree of life that we must cling to must begin with a call for us, all of us, to be humble, to humble ourselves so that we do not think about what is in it for us first while ignoring others, but instead think deeply about the collective community, especially those who far too long have been ostracized and marginalized by that legal system, by societal norms, by legal norms. That is what our American legal system tries to do by understanding that the Constitution is a living document. And that is why who sits on the Supreme Court is so impactful on the society that we hope to build and create. But that is why we also believe that Torah is a living document. That the legal system is not about I, me first, but Anochi, a humble self that suggests Ukshe'ani la'atzmi ma'ani, that if I am only for myself, then what's the point? Then what am I doing here? Then what are we at all? We do not believe in throwing away the Torah. That's how our community would vote if this was an off-Broadway show. Even if this text that we see as divine is also divinely flawed, we believe Torah is not set in stone. As Ben Bogbog teaches in Mishnah Avot, we say hafoch ba ve'apech ba, that we roll it and roll it, turn it and turn it, for everything is in it. Midrash says that there are shivim panim Torah, that there are 70 faces of Torah. That Torah is about interpreting and reinterpreting time and time again, that our legal system evolves. We reanalyze Torah to help us find meaning in it now, even and especially if that is a different meaning than was found in those very same verses thousands or hundreds or even just a few years ago. So may our holy legal system, may the Torah that we received this Shabbat as we re-experience Revelation, may the Constitution that we constantly debate in the courts and in the chambers of Congress, may we look at both of them with Anochi, with a humble sense of self, by putting others before ourselves, especially looking out for how our legal systems support the vulnerable, the marginalized, and the forgotten, with making sure that Torah is truly an Eitz Chaim Hi, by declaring that we the people, in this case we the Jewish people, truly represents all people. Shabbat Shalom.